Doing this afternoon. It is. It's time for Art Fight.
I'm so glad I was actually able to do more than one piece this year, because I don't know why I was just like, I did one!
You doubled your output!
I've doubled my output, I'm almost about to triple, I'm in the middle of trying to triple it right now.
Watching Twitter fuck itself, and not in the fun way. True!
Justin is currently trying to enrich the chicken.
Good for Justin.
Let Hangorita get a little bit of a spray.
We bought her a little mister for her, for out in front of her coop because it gets so hot.
Hot in Topeka.
Hot in Topeka. Hi, Charlotte! Yeah, we're doing some, I prepped 4 art fight attacks. I already drew 3.
I'm hoping that I get at least 1 revenge this year.
Hello.
Saradust, hello.
That is me.
It is you.
Yeah, we're gonna do some, doing some art fight attacks to start with today.
Oh, that's awesome. I love art and fighting.
I haven't done any prep. I've just been staring at the website all day. Already drew 3. That's efficiency right there. I'm a monster.
I believe it. Okay. I need you guys to hear me out on what might be my greatest character I've ever come up with in my entire life.
Okay.
Ninja Officer.
Good start.
He is a ninja, and he is an officer.
An officer of what?
Professional wrestling.
Immaculate.
He shows up and he's like, it's me, I'm Ninja Officer, you're under arrest, and then he fucking dies immediately.
Oh, thank God, I thought he was a cop.
No, he would never be a cop, he'd never be cringe.
I've been, but I'm more active in the first week than I am throughout the rest of the month, obviously, because I'm just more excited.
Yeah.
But I pre-prepped 2 videos to go out this month, so I don't have to worry about that. So you'll have at least, so you'll have 2 videos come out in July. One is the first Kit Kat video, and the other is the Color Wheel Art Challenge. Then, but this month, the goal is to just focus on doing art fight.
I knew I was gonna hate myself for picking something more complicated, but it's fine.
I'm excited for the, I'm excited for the Kit Kat video. I've already filmed the... filmed, air quotes. I've already done the artwork for the, for part two. And that's up on my Patreon, if that's, that artwork's already up on Patreon if you want to see it. I think it's also up on Ko-Fi if you've, if you're a future site tier, you, tier as well. Our goal is to focus on art fight and watch the samurai anime. Yeah, correct. No, you're right.
Raw. Oh, no, speaking of anime, Heaton, I'm gonna be real with you. I'm not ready for a world without Stiletto Sunday tomorrow.
I have been putting it off, and I haven't watched the last couple of weeks because I've just simply not been in the headspace to be sad.
That's perfectly based.
I hope that it ends well.
I hope so too, because like, I didn't know that it only was picked up for like two cores. So I got to the next episode preview and I was like, wait, what do you mean this is the last episode?
Yep.
Yeah, no, it's like not in a bad way. It's more in a, I was not expecting them to wrap everything up next episode kind of way, you know?
I have to be careful when I'm scrolling through Patreon. If I go too fast, I can jump scared by dragon cock. Listen. People wanted a place to see my NSFW artwork as little as I post, so. I did do another one.
No way.
Mm-hmm. I have to touch it up because I forgot to draw the fucking scales on my mermaid, but.
Does this mean she's over 30 because of how mermaids work?
What do you mean?
Korkiko in Water 7 says that when a mermaid hits 30, their tail splits so they can also live on land.
Oh no. I didn't intend that. I forgot about that world building detail.
That's kinda raw, actually.
No, I just had it like that. I forgot.
I didn't know what her age was, which is why I asked.
She's around the rest of the crew's age. She's like, I mean, she's probably close to it. She's probably like 25. Hello, Sunny!
No way, Mr. Zenny.
No, Sunny.
Sunny, okay. I'm out of it right now. I'm just trying to make a Tumblr because apparently Twitter's going to shit again.
Must be Tuesday.
Isn't it funny? We all jumped ship from Tumblr to Twitter because Tumblr was going to shit, and now that Twitter's going to shit, everybody's going back.
That's really funny to me.
Same with Reddit.
I'm gonna be honest, the main reason I've been using Reddit is for the Hyrule Engineers subreddit, because some of the stuff people are building in that game is fucking crazy.
Heaton Mitsuru, give me your art fight. Sure. If the site's up. if it's not, I'll have to comb through I can just do it on- I can just go through Twitter, hang on. You're welcome, Sunny. Man, I post a lot about One Piece.
Understandable.
I'm gonna be right back.
You do that. You're on my hit list. I'm going to get you. What team are you on, Sunny? Almost as if. One Piece. Good? I know, right? God forbid. Werewolf? Okay, so we're on the same team. If you wanna attack me, there you go. There's my art fight. Oh, I don't care either. I also friendly fire, so it's fine. I think the only thing that you... that happens with friendly fire is I think you get less points.
Yeah, that's about it.
Like, you get more... you obviously get more points if you're attacking the other team, but... you still get points for doing friendly fire.
I learned that someone that does a web... that does a webcomic that I like is on the opposite team as me for Art Fight, and I'm like, I'm gonna draw my favorite character of yours because they're on there. Fuck you, an excuse to do fan art.
Most of my friends are vampires. Works for me. Mainly hang around oddly satisfying and crappy design. Occasionally justice served in nuclear revenge because I'm a petty. Bitch. I'm not a fan of the way that Reddit functions, so I don't use it. Father Son's ref is cropped, but while it loads, predicting he's a baddie. He is! He has a hot wizard boyfriend? Soon to be husband for real? As opposed to the husband in theory?
To be fair, they are legally real married. They were just fake, treating it as fake marriage to real marriage.
I want to draw the animatic of that fucking TikTok of the guy who's like, we committed marriage fraud. And then he explains it. And then they're like, yeah, but like, did you actually get married? And he goes, yeah, we like signed the paperwork and everything. And he goes, then you didn't commit fraud, gamer. You're just married. He's a baddie, it must be said. Oh, Sonny, I have great news. Adam Frankenstein, hold my hand, please. More Adam fans. Fans for the Adam girlies.
Correct.
I thought about most- there may be a- maybe one of these other years, I thought about, like, just putting- like, just putting the cast on there, but I was like, nah, I only want one for right now. And I feel like Adam is one of the most fun to draw. Because of his varying skin tones and his cool eyes.
Coloring this is going to be a fucking nightmare, but it's fine.
He's a character in a dating sim that I'm making, Sonny, so you'll be able to hold his hand. Feel bad for missing a lot of these because I don't know who the characters are. It's okay. Oh no! Charlotte, that just means you'll have to come back more often. Oh no. What a terrible situation for you to be in. Sorry, I'm back. I died! Listen, Adam's fat daddy milkers do appear to be, a desirable trait. I didn't intend that, but, you know, here we are. I know nothing about your OCs because you don't tell me. Listen, we've talked about this anytime for any provocation. The slightest provocation, Sonny, I'll do it. His fat daddy milker's eating, please. You need to DM me first. I'm always online. I hate you. I'm sorry. Yeah, I put up quite a few of my baby children.
I put up Ash.
Good, because she's baby and she deserves to have more art. love Ash. I love her so much. Father Stone was up last year as well. I want to see if... He didn't get very many, which I think is funny. Oh, okay. I'm starting to think you make every man you make cute. Not intentionally. Loved the dice video, Heaton. Thank you, James. I loved the dice. Sing time, sing time. Yeah, sing time. Hang on, I got up, I guess. I'll do what I did last time, which means I will simply go into the playlist and hit shuffle. Where the fuck is the playlist? Hello? There you are. Okay. Ooh! Okay. All right. This is a personal favorite of mine. Okay. Waiting for the instrumental, sorry. Five men were told a lie. They've grasped upon ill fortune. They plans to live their lives, but could not live immune. Deteriorated minds, they tore at flesh like snakes. And all that's left behind is the will to stay awake. Have you forgotten so easily? We are you. We are the madness that lurks within you. We are the animal instinct of greed. We notice when the day breaks anew. We no longer wish to be freed. An experiment with faults. Bother to write a monodine. No memory of the results. No results could restore the memory. The commies hadn't a clue that one's sanity could be nullified. They offered help, they knew that the forgiveness could not be certified. Have you forgotten so easily? We are you. We are the madness that lurks within you. We are the animal instinct of greed. We witness when the day breaks anew. We no longer wish to be freed. There's an instrumental break here. We are you. We are the madness that lurks within you. We are the animal instinct of greed. We witness when the day breaks anew. We no longer wish to be freed. This is called The Experiment. It's by Steam Pianist. It's a Vocaloid song I really like.
I was worried you forgot for a hot second.
No. said a song about the fucking Russian sleep experiment. Yes. Another one. Okay. Another one. All right. No, I have a playlist. I have a playlist of ones I know really well that I sound good singing. That's what I do. Okay, next one. Oh, okay. I'm gonna make some people's days. Hang on. Right here, right now, I'd put the offer out. I don't wanna chase you down, but no, you see it. Run with me, and I can cut you free of the treachery and all you're creeping. I don't sing that well. For something mythical. If it's crazy, live a little crazy. Sensible, professional, or you could risk it all and see. Don't you wanna get away from the same old part you gotta play? Cause I got what you need. Come with me and take the ride. Take me to the other side. I can do what you do. We can be like me. In the cage, or you'll finally take this key. Oh, damn, suddenly you're free to fly. Take you to the other side. My friend, you wanna cut me in to tell you that it just won't happen. So thanks, but no, I think I'm good to go. Enjoy the life you say I'm trapped in. And a few, and this whole show you do. You're not something, really, it's something. Loved among the swells, and we don't pick up peanut shells. I'll have to leave that up to you. You know that I'm okay with the uptown part I get to play, cause I got what I need and I don't wanna take the ride. Don't need to see the other side. I don't do like you do. I'm good to do like me. Ain't in a cage, so I don't need to take a key. Oh, damn, can't you see I'm doing fine? Don't need to see the other side. Your days, whiskey and misery, parties and plays. When mixed up with you, I'd be the talk of the town. Disgraced and disowned, another one of the clowns. But you could finally live a little, finally laugh a little. Just give you the freedom to dream, and it'll wake you up and cure your aching. Take your walls and start them breaking. Now that's a deal that seems worth taking. But I guess I'll leave that up to you. That's intriguing, but to go would cost me greatly. So what percentage of the show would I be taking? Fair enough, you'd want a piece of all the action. I'd give you 7, we could shake and make it happen. I wasn't born this morning, 18 would be just fine. Just go ahead and ask for nickels on the dime. 15, I'll do 12, maybe 9, 10? And you wanna get away to a whole new part you're gonna play, cause I got what you need, so come with me and take the ride. Take you to the other side. Do like I do. If you do like me, forget the cage, cause we know how to make a key. Oh, damn, suddenly we're free to fly. Take you to the other side. To the other side. To the other side. To the other side. We're going to the other side. All right.
You did it.
I did it. We no longer should be free, me suddenly 14 again. Russian sleep experiment's my favorite. You're lucky I'm saving my points, otherwise I'd do it again. This is gonna be a long one, so it'd be the time for it. I have some I have some in here that'll fuck up my throat for sure. I'm waiting for the right time. Did I not? There we go. Did infuse those layers down. If I save up 10k points, I can redeem Theater Kid and come sit here and aid you. We have to, if we talk a little more, I'll add you into the server. Because this is the one I stream in is a private server.
This one's fun, because I get to practice.
There's a server? Yeah. Learning. I have, Doug, I was just going to make you a voice note. Well, you can just do that. You do !Discord, you have the community Discord, but I stream in a private server. I'm in your Discord. Yeah, that's my community Discord. The one I stream in is a personal Discord. Headass. This is, okay. One of my, like, consistent things about Art Fight is that I don't check when I first, like, when I first grab a character, like, I don't check their details.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just, like, I have a room in my personal server that only I can see where I just put all of the references. And I grab a PNG and then the link so that I can go back to their page, right? But, I don't typically, like, check, like, what the character is so much. So, like, I saw this girl and I was like, I like her. She's cool. I wonder what her deal is. And then I started drawing her this morning and I was like, wait a minute. Is she a robot? Because if she's a robot, it's gonna affect how I color her. It's gonna affect my shading. But she's not. She's a mimic. I'm gonna make her a little metallic though. Mainly because she's supposed, because like I was like, okay, so oh, she's not a robot. Okay, she's a mimic. And they're like, yeah, she's typically this pair of earrings. And I'm like, oh, so I'll make her a little shiny. I'll just make her, she gets to be a little shiny as a treat. It's also fun to translate, like, design elements, like her eyes in this image, into my art style, because I'm like, how the fuck? But I'll just do it like that.
I partially picked this character that I'm currently drawing because, like, well, it's a little complicated, but it also gives me a good excuse to practice drawing, like, eye makeup on a character.
True. Such a music mood, I want to speedrun a song. Which should I speedrun a song on? Jester song would be fun. Manhunt song would be fun. I'm ill. I like your Jester song.
It's hard to tell what's shading and what's...
How do you speedrun a song? You sing it double tempo, I'd imagine. If you sing the bridge twice in a row, then it means you don't have to sing it later. if you sing out the first four notes of Megalovania pitch perfect, then you frame skip half of the Undertale soundtrack.
I'm not gonna whitewash anyone's characters. You can't make me.
See, I don't have to worry about whitewashing people's characters because I do this magic thing. It's called fucking color picking.
You can always color pick in the wrong spot. If you don't know how to color pick, you will fuck yourself over. But I know how to color pick because I'm not cringe.
Pick the mid-tones, you fucking morons. It's not difficult. Also, fun fact, I'm gonna say this once again for the people in the back. Don't fucking shade your goddamn references.
Luckily for me, I don't typically do any, like, but I typically do, like, a cell shaded where I don't, like, blend it. So it's easier to color pick.
Don't shade your references, crafty!
Yeah! Don't put a billion overlays on them, leave them flat color, crafty! Do you know how much of a pain in the ass it was to try and draw Khan for a bit, for a funny bit that happened? It was a pain in my ass!
Using his fucking blending modes, you stupid dickhead! I love her fucking sick comment of glasses. Well, let's do... This is a good one. Because it still preserves the... Somebody whitewashes my bright blue tiefling. I'll go two tones lighter just to prove to you that it can be done. I don't know how you'd whitewash my tiefling. You want to see?
You want to find out?
You want to see me do it again? Oh, it's just all the... It's all the same tone? Always has been, dumbass. I don't know. Fuck. My internet is shitting. Help!
This whole thing is fucking patterned and I'm gonna die, but I'll make it work. I chose this fate. I decided to color to draw a jester character.
Haha, that's a you mistake.
They were cool.
The other thing is, okay, I want to show you, I want to show you a character that I drew already. Today. So I found this on Artfight, and I was like, I don't know what the fuck this is. I don't know what the fuck this character is. So I made my best approximation, right? And one of the things about like Artfight that I like is interpreting other people's art styles. I did my best. I think that's right.
That looks right to me.
But like, I don't know if they're just a giant eyeball or like what the deal is. That's kind of what I interpreted this to be. I'm not totally sure. I don't know what her deal is, but I like her. So I drew her. Reminds me of Blacephalon a little bit. But like, one of my favorite things about Artfight is grabbing these designs that are relatively esoteric and being like, I can figure that out. I can draw that in my art style, we'll see.
It's fine.
I always lean towards grabbing the references of characters that look nothing like my normal art. Purely because I really like trying to work them into my own, like, style. It's a great style exercise for me. Ultra Beasts need to come back. Game Freak can't drop cosmic horrors on us. Okay, can we talk for a minute while we're on this topic? Can we fucking talk about the fucking Pokemon Go ads for the Ultra Beasts? And how that was just straight up fucking found footage horror? Permission to speedrun a mini song for your SMP character. Please, I'll cry. I'll only cry a little, a lot. If you write a fucking song for me, I'll cry. I'll cry on stream. Yeah, the fucking Zerkatree one is actual fucking nightmare fuel. It's so creepy. The fucking Nihiligo one was spooky too. Like, they were so fucking creepy. I was stoked about it. I'd love more, like, Pokemon horror. You know what I mean? Like, I know that's an insane ask, but, like...
The Graveyard was also a snuff film.
Yeah, please, never forget the fact that the fucking Graveyard trailer for announcement, that's a fucking snuff film. We watched that woman die. Cry, bitch. TLDR of your character vibe. Like, I get the eyes part. You have a mother dragon. You want to go home. Yeah. The main thing is that, like... The main theme that I'm kind of going for... And I've talked to Mally about this a little bit. So, like... So I've established this with her as well. Is, like... I'm very... how you'd describe it, really. I guess innocent is the word. I am a conduit for something that is greater than I am. And I'm sort of like, I'm not the threat. It's the thing that uses, the thing that works through me is. If that helps. It's not a video where someone turned the Ultra Beast into SCPs. Most of them are easy to contain if requiring constant surveillance, except Guzzlord. Well, yeah, the fucking... How do you fucking contain Guzzlord? He'd just eat. He'll just chew right through. I love metal and paint. I love painting metal. I get to make it so shiny.
So, I mostly just stuck to new posts. I didn't try looking for any specific tags. Aside from a couple of One Piece.
But I'm gonna probably grab some One Piece ones later today too. I've been time-lapsing these instead of like recording them normally because I do just want to like, instead of like talking about all of these individually, I want to like, because, like, I don't know a lot about these characters, and I'm gonna do a lot of them in one day. Instead, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna be like, I'll write a journal for these 30 days. And then just be like, alright, this is what I was feeling today. 20 minutes? Yeah, 20 minutes. Powerful. It's frozen in ice and asleep. Pray to God, every religion, that it doesn't wake up because we're fucked. Is Kartana a grass type? I thought for sure Kartana would have been a steel type.
Which Pokemon?
Kartana.
The newer one?
One of the Ultra Beasts. The samurai looking one.
The paper?
The paper, yeah. I thought he would have been steel type.
No, he looks like paper. You want to know what doesn't look like a steel type, but it is Jirachi?
It's because it's a star.
Doesn't make sense to me.
It is bamboo, dual type. Oh! I love this character's design.
It's hard to tell what's just artistic expression and what's actually, like, on the character.
Right! Yeah! It's a big one with me, too. It's like, what the fuck is this? I'm here for a dragon- Yeah, Dragon Fruit Dragon Boy! I like them. Colors of dragon fruit as well, so I think you get like a really good palette inherent.
I think even if I get one revenge picture, I think I will be content with this art fight.
Oh, yeah, dog. Listen. First of all, if you want ref sheets, my commissions are open. I do ref sheets. Mine are maybe a little expensive, but I draw ref sheets. I don't typically draw ref sheets for my characters very often.
Yeah, I typically draw a ref image. The most I've ever done of a ref sheet is Ash, because hers is more complicated, being a Togruta.
Have to draw her funny stripes.
You gotta know what it looks like at different angles.
But as somebody who also has, like, a million OCs, yeah. I tend to only draw ref sheets for characters I draw, like, a lot.
I tend to make ref sheets truly once it becomes too much of a pain in the ass to keep looking at the other images I've drawn of them. So Alice is probably going to get an updated one here soon, because she's gone through some tweaks since I've drawn her last, since I drew her main reference the first time.
Have to draw her with her Hawaiian shirt.
Just draw her whole outfit refs, just being like, pre-straw hats, current width straw hats, pre-time skip, post-time skip.
You call your viewers cousins, right? No, cousins are my, my points to myself. My, fans are, my viewers are called my Legionnaires, but, cousins within the context of the SMP is other Endermen. I don't remember how that... I think it was you, actually, Brooke. I think you're the one who started me doing that.
Because it was like... Because we had our own little thing going in our RLCraft server, and you didn't want us to hurt them.
Yeah,
so like, oh, so they're like cousins.
Yeah. And then they started doing it and started calling them cousins, and then I started doing it. So now every time I... When you hear me during streams mention, like, something something the cousins, I'm talking about, like, other Endermen.
I still call them cousins, even though, even if I'm not playing with you. That's just what they are now.
I've always liked the Ender people. Endermen are cool. That's why I wanted to be one, is because I think they're really cool, guys.
Also, just briefest aside, I know I also picked this jester person because, like, I feel like making a clown slash jester type character is one of the hardest fucking designs you could ever undertake if you want it to be, like, a really good one. Because you have to, like, you have to make the asymmetry look balanced.
As somebody who had to do it for Juby, yeah.
If you want it to look authentic and if you want it to look correct and not just lame.
Oh yeah, I was gonna say, Sunny, you, a fellow jester lover. You were on my art fight. You didn't see my jester? You didn't see the funny little clown?
To be fair, the site is probably chugging at a snail's pace at the current moment.
Do you like her, my funny little clown?
I should draw my funny little clown again.
Funny little clown baby?
She's actually a cryptid that has... saying human skin suit sounds more insidious than it is, but...
Can I ask an art-related question? No, you may not. You're not allowed to ask me any questions. How dare you? Donate 10 subs and then you can ask. Of course you can ask me a question, Charlotte. Crying emoji. Yeah, you can ask me whatever you want. That was quick! Already on it. You've designed it. I have! Have you ever designed a character out of spite? I have, Charlotte, I have. Let me introduce you to her. I did, and she's one of Daedalus's favorites.
Is it Raistra?
No.
I mean, Raistra was also out of spite, wasn't it?
Raistra wasn't out of spite. There's a difference between making a character out of spite and making a character to prove a point. Raistra I made to prove a point. But I made Eve out of spite. I made her out of spite. And she's one of Daedalus's favorites. Daedalus loves Eve. She's a fucking, I thought you were gonna pull up Yua! I did also concept out an entire video game that I'm working on with Skittles to... out of spite because of how much I fucking hate Yandere Dev. I'm working on... I made Eve out of spite. For one particular shit Dragon Ball fan, we will not say his name, he doesn't deserve the clout. Because he's kind of a homophobic, racist piece of shit. And so I was like, you know what? I'm gonna make a character that is the epitome of everything you hate and is still canon compliant, as is my want and way. Back to my old roots of trolling Naruto RP forums. And so I made Eve. She is a transgender lesbian Namekian. In her home universe, she is Kami. She can turn orange, and she has a hot Majin girlfriend who she loves very much.
That's one of Ellie's, right?
Yeah, it's on me. She interacted with humans for the first time and found out what women were and was like, I could be that?
That's an option?
And then rounded up the Dragon Balls and grabbed Shenron by the throat and was like, that! Trans my gender! Make me that! And Shenron's like, alright, I guess.
The fun part about digital art is copy and pasting.
I also, one of the things, by the way, the reason that Heartstrings kind of ended up getting shunted back a little bit is twofold. One, I wanna explain this a little bit, because, like, it's kind of why I want En Passant to be my first, I think, is for a number of reasons. One of which, this was a very difficult thing to explain, so maybe this won't make sense. But Justin seems...
I think it makes sense.
I was gonna say, but Brooke and Justin seem to get it when I managed to explain it. So I, as a creative, like to make a lot of different things. Like, both genre and, like, medium-wise. And the more I sat and thought about it, the more I thought, like, I want to make something that's very in the middle of, like, all of my stylistic preferences, as well as, like, my tonal and genre preferences. So, like, I don't want to make something that's pure horror as my first thing that I publish, mainly for the same reason I don't want to make something that's, like, for example, something like Monster Match that's more, like, drama and romance, you know. I don't want to do that because I don't want to make something that pigeonholes me into, like, one particular genre.
Or expectation,
right. Like, I don't want to make Heartstrings and then when I start working on Monster Match, people go in with the expectation that that's going to be a horror game, because it won't. I don't have any plans for any, like, overt horror elements in that. You know? And I want something that, like, that A, will be relatively low stakes to execute, and then B, something that's very, like, something that if I published a follow-up, like, the next thing, then people will be like, oh, okay, so it's gonna be more of this. And then when they see that it's kind of that, then they're more willing to be like, oh, okay, you know what I mean? Like, I don't want to put it, like, maybe in a way that makes a little more sense. I don't want to publish Silent Hill 2 and then follow it up with Dream Daddy, you know what I mean? Like, I want to... Because then people are going to go into Dream Daddy expecting something that I'm just not going to have. So I thought En Passant would be a great place to start. Because it's got some spooky elements. It's got some horror, some dark themes, but it's got some romance, some drama.
I think afterwards, as like an in-between project, you should do Out of Water.
I love Out of Water. I would love to work on that as a second project. Hacker supervillain called Cheat Code, who believes he's living in a video game, like nothing is real. He's also a complete pathetic loser. He's literally every negative gamer stereotype aspect rolled into one. Basically, he's a mirror to all toxic gamers online by saying, "See this loser? He's you. Dog." Listen, I wish nothing for the best, but the best for you. Here's hoping that people understand that, and he doesn't get Patrick Bateman.
Have people baby-girlified Patrick Bateman?
They have, but like, in two very polar opposite ways, which I think is funny. I saw somebody talking about this, that like, the phenomenon of Patrick Bateman memes is very interesting.
Mm-hmm.
No, send it to me after stream. I don't want to cry on stream. Thank you, though. Like, 50% of it is like weird shitty douche bros who are like, "Oh man, he's so cool, literal Chad alpha male Patrick Bateman," and then the other 50% are women and queer people photoshopping fucking cat ears on him and playing that clip of him walking down the hallway with headphones on, but it's like fucking Miku or something.
Mm-hmm.
So Patrick Bateman is being baby girlified, but both in an ironic and an unironic way, and I find that very interesting. I'm so glad that we live in a society currently where both Patrick Bateman and Call of Duty now belong to the girls and the gays. Me. I'll never play Call of Duty. I have no interest in its story whatsoever. Also me. Gets brainwashed by TikTok into buying Call of Duty and playing it for its story. Listen, if they make a new Modern Warfare 3, I'll buy it and play it, because I'm kind of invested in Soap and Ghost now. American Psycho, the only good role Jared Leto ever had. I keep forgetting that that was Jared Leto. Mainly because I keep forgetting that Jared Leto's that old.
It's something that I forgore on the regular, too. Patterns are hard.
Listen, I just think that whore in the man in the Mescal mask needs to get redacted. Listen, I agree. It's why I pay Blue Giragi dollars every month. So that they can provide me with all of the artwork. Jared Leto also forgets he's old. I don't know if I'd even say necessarily that Jared Leto's old. I just keep forgetting he's as old as he is.
Like, Paul Rudd does not look...
I keep thinking he's in, like, his 30s, and he's not. Paul Rudd is also a fucking vampire of some kind.
He's the American vampire. Well, Araki is the Japanese vampire.
You cannot convince me that Hirohiko Araki is human. His fucking genetics are doing some... Either he's a vampire or his halon is on point because he looks fantastic. Paul Rudd's in his 50s? How? Exactly, right?
He's not racist.
It's true. Oh, being racist ages you like 1,000 years. Like a fucking, like a fucking horror movie mummy.
Have you seen an attractive looking racist? Probably, but for the most part, they age very poorly.
When you are racist and or homophobic, you do not age well. It's factually true! Being a bigot, like, look at people who are, like, historically bigoted when they were younger as opposed to now. You age like fucking nobody's business. Every time you say a slur, you just fucking, you age. It shaves 20 years off of your appearance, like the fucking portrait of Dorian Gray. I will. Thank you, Sunny. I will and I'll cry. I'm gonna sob about it. Being racist is like smoking. The moment people see it, your magnitude's less attractive. See, okay. Listen. I know that smoking's bad for you, right? Like, I know, it's gross. I don't like it. I don't like it in real life, right? Tucks hair behind ear. However... It's smoking hot and smells good. Send tweet. Exactly! Exactly! Well, if it smells good, then that's an autism thing, but like, because I also like the smell of secondhand smoke, which is why I smoke candles? What the fuck was that sentence about to be? It's why I burn tobacco candles. typically, but like... Eaton, we all know if you like a theme in fiction, it means you like it in real life. Also, hello, Chezzy B. There's tobacco candles? Yeah! One of the ones I have up here, actually. I'm feeling for the lid. This one? No. It's one of the ones Dio gave me. Smells like tobacco. Because I like the smell. Yeah, if you like caustic scents, like if you like the smell of like gasoline or cigarette smoke or like ammonia.
Hand sanitizer, baby.
Hand sanitizer. Then that's a sign you might be autistic. I didn't know that one until I did my first autism screening. I said yes to most of the things that they asked me, but that one I was not aware of, and I just kind of paused, and he went, "What?" And I'm like, "No, I do." And internally I was like, "Oh, fuck. This is why I sniff the gas pumps, isn't it? Fuck. I'm fucked. Oh, God. Oh, no. Oh, jeez. Oh, Rick." Also, hello, Sims Mage. Welcome, welcome. So what's an art fight? Okay, yeah. So a few of- it just occurred to me as well. Some of you might not even really know what I'm doing. So, art fight, is a how you would really... It's a big art trade.
A competitive art trade.
It's a competitive art trade. Basically what happens is you get sorted into two teams. This year it's werewolves and vampires. And what you do is you draw other people's characters to get points. Whichever team gets the most points at the end of the month wins. What do you win? Bragging rights and art of your characters, mostly. It's just something to do for fun. Just one big...
The end is in sight.
Just one big, friendly little competition between artists. You get art of your characters, they get art of theirs. You get the practice. And you get bragging rights. You get another thing you can pin to your Twitter banner. And music work to do, but have a great day, Heat and Re. Remind about your OCs later or I'll kill you.
You gotta be specific.
We'll talk about it later. Scoot, scoot. What do you mean specific? We'll talk about it later. Let me know when you have time. We'll discuss. I have so many OCs, Sunny. I have so much time. Just tell me when you're free. I don't care. I'll bring water. Cool. I'll let you know. But I love doing our fight. I was talking about this on Crafty's stream earlier today. I like getting the practice. I like doing the work. I like having just something to do every day. I like the structure. It's part of why I really enjoy doing, like, month-long art challenges. Like OC October or, Mermaid. It's nice to just have something to... It's nice every day to have something I can just wake up and do, you know what I mean?
For me, it starts at feeling like a chore. And it's hard for me sometimes.
Understandable.
Even though I want to do it. And I feel like my art just ends up looking not as good as it could. Sometimes.
Yeah, if that's... It's like, 100% one of the things that, like, I understand why some people don't do them. Because, yeah, that's a totally valid way to be. It's just, it helps me. I don't know. I'm autistic. I like the routine. Also, thank you for the follow!
It's mostly a case of, like, I want to do it, but a lot of the times it just ends up feeling... I don't know.
No, I get it. It totally makes sense. It's just one of those things. It's like, you said it perfectly. The minute it starts feeling like a chore, it's not fun anymore. Oh, it's because I have the wrong fucking brush selected. That'd be why. Christ. Also, hello, Moonlight! It's not Artist Mermaid is my favorite, strictly because I like mermaids. True. I like Kaijun. Ooh! If I was better at drawing monsters, I'd do Kaijun. I'm thinking about, instead of doing OC October this year, I'm thinking about doing Goretober. I could use the practice. Hello, Imagine Kaijus! Welcome, welcome! Also, yes, there is a Kaijun! Goretober? It's just what it sounds like. Every day you get a prompt and you have to draw a certain kind of gore. Sir Scott a lot. Hello, welcome, welcome. All kinds of new viewers today. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We're just working on Art Fight.
I'm doing it too, much to my...
Saw Art Fight and was curious, didn't get mine set up in time. Aw!
You can join, you're just, your team will be randomized, although you can swap it.
Yeah. I think you can join late. I'm certainly not going to mock you for it.
I'm just going to hope and pray I get a couple of revenge pieces, because it would suck if I got none.
I know that's not the point,
but...
It's not. You got to do it for the fun. Do it for the growth, for the practice. Do it to make baby artists day. That's part of why I do it. This is another thing too, is I always try and grab the references of at least one person I could tell pretty much for sure as a kid. Cause like, I know how it feels to like, to join in on these kinds of things and then just not, like, and be like, oh, I hope somebody who's, like, air quotes, good at art, you know, attacks me. And then not have that happen and how sad you feel.
Yeah.
Hush, good at art you are. I meant it more like in the way like with other people, you know. That's why I said air quotes is good at art. Because being good at art's subjective, you know? There's tons of people out there who might not like my style, for example. And that's totally fine. Some people like realism. Some people like digital painting.
I at the very least hope that the people that I'm doing the fight, the art for, acknowledge the art that I'm doing for them. And I worry that if I'm drawing someone's that's like, I consider they have like techniques I consider better than me, I hope they don't feel like, oh, this fucking sucks.
Love drawing people's OCs. So do I! Because especially, like, as somebody who, like, gets crazily excited whenever anyone draws my characters, it feels nice to be able to provide that feeling for somebody else.
Yeah.
It's part of what I like about getting commissioned, actually. Naturally, part of it's the money, but the other part of it is that it's... Like, for example, I'm going to call Wandering out. Every time that Wandering commissions me and then writes long paragraphs about how much they love my artwork and how happy they are, and they post their art, the art everywhere, and I see them tag me in it, and it just makes me really happy. Doing it for fun. What are you, healthy? Art Fight is one of the things I do for fun. Doing, like, I think part of, like, I really liked doing Mermaid this year. But something I want to talk about in that video is, like, doing it for content really changed how it felt, you know?
And yeah, I understand that.
And I don't think it changed it, like, in a way that, like, I would never do it, or even that I would never do it for content again. But I want to talk about that. Like, Because, like I said, I've done Mermaid, I do OC October, I've done Inktober, I do all of those things, right? And because I love doing art challenges. Because I do them because they're fun. But, like, doing it for a reason other than because I felt like it really did change the vibe of the process. It's why I'm trying to do Art Fight a little differently. I want to see if this feels a little better. If doing it this way, where, like, I'm just going to talk about my experience working on it as opposed to, like, the pieces themselves.
I am excited to get my hands on editing the Mermaid video.
I'm excited for you.
I couldn't tell you why. I know it's going to be a lot of work, and I'm going to have to figure out a fuckload of different songs, but it's fine. I'll figure it out.
So many instrumental Little Mermaid covers.
Well, I'm not going to do anything that's going to risk getting a copyright claim by something stupid, but you're going to be hearing a lot of aquatic themes from things, I think.
It's probably a good idea.
What the scallop?
I also, for that one in particular, I wanted to, like, because I don't follow the prompts for Mermaids. I'm a fucking rebel.
You're a fucking...
But,
I'm not allowed to say the next word.
But, like, also, I just do it because, like, I like to draw different kinds of fish. I tried to include a couple of cool fun facts about the fish that I drew every day. $20 says Aquarium Park gets used.
Aquarium Park was used in, I think, one of the not... Will's Aquarium Park, fuck you! It's a good song!
I was gonna say, Brooke likes Mario.
Is that a bit?
No,
It's from Sonic.
Oh. Then yes, it is a bit.
Aquarium Park from Colors is very good. Fuck you.
It's a bit. If it makes me look stupid, then it's a bit. I don't play a lot of Sonic! I'm sorry! I've played one Sonic game. Yes, one Sonic game. Ever in my whole life.
What the fuck is wrong with you, Heaton?
I don't know. I just was never a Sonic kid.
Okay, Heaton, we're gonna fix that. I can't actually give games in Steam because Steam is still being a giant piece of shit.
I started reading the comics, if that counts for anything.
I mean, it depends.
Okay, I need to talk about this dude. I love this little guy. I love him. Wait. Hang on, I have to show you the funny little guy. This is the funny little guy. I love him. Look at him!
What guy?
Look at this funny little guy!
I mean, they're not little because they're 5'8", but, like, little guy energy.
This is a little guy. I don't care that they're 6'8". This is a little guy. Look at this little guy. I love them. I love this little guy so much.
I have a stupid question because I'm not sure what Art Fight is. And I don't think I'm just supposed to give you, like... whatever.
No, it's a...
competitive art trades.
They're competitive art trades.
Okay. I just wanted to make sure because I didn't want to, like, accidentally or otherwise, like, do something that I'm not allowed to do, you know?
Yeah. No, they're, these are other people's OCs that they posted and were like, draw them if you dare! And I'm like, damn, you're right, I do. I do dare. Did you see my post? What did you say, Kamara?
Oh, hello? Okay. Anyways, yes, I do like this.
Can you see
design.
Who the reference belongs really... to? I can. I save, well, because I always save the, I save the image and the character page because you have to tag, because you have to, there's a number tag that each character gets, and that's how you register who gets, that who's being tagged in the posts. This is
I always bookmark them.
Lining and coloring this is going to be an absolute fucking bitch because they're goo, and I have a special way that I draw goo. But it's...
anyways, let me see what Sonic games are on sale on Steam.
I have Sonic Mania.
Okay, you have Sonic Mania. Good. Sonic Frontiers has gone from $60 to $30.
I heard Sonic Frontiers was good. I watched Salty DK Dan play it.
Yeah. So go ahead and get Sonic Frontiers because it's really good. If you like a decent visual novel, especially since you've been apparently reading the comics, I would wait until after you play, unless you know about all the spoilers with Sonic Frontiers.
But I got Sonic Mania, and I didn't get Sonic Frontiers because I heard that Sonic had a really rough transition to 3D.
You are.
Ethan. That's a bold-faced lie.
Look, Adventure and Adventure 2 are very scrunkly.
Adventure and Adventure 2 were actually really good. The transition to 3D was actually not all that bad. The worst parts about that game were Amy and Big, and even then, it wasn't Sonic. It wasn't Sonic that had the rough transition to 3D. It was Sonic's friends. And even then.
Sonic, Stellar Sill is the name of the person who made Banzai. I love them. I love this funny little dude. Just a funky little guy. I love them.
Yeah, anyways,
funky little dude. Just a little gooey boy.
The Adventure Duology is also actually a really good option. Thank you, Fenrir. Heaton, if not for the laws of Twitter being a giant bitch and not letting me get games on Steam, you would be forced to accept Sonic Adventure and Sonic Adventure 2 on Steam.
I thought you were about to be like, were it not for the laws of this land, I'd have slain you.
No. Well, I mean that too, but like...
Do you want to make it worse?
Yes.
Do you want to know the one Sonic game I've actually played?
What's the one Sonic game you've actually played?
The original Sonic Riders.
It's actually not all that like it's not like an incredible game or anything, but like, you know, like
every time I say that, I get a like, oh my god, and I'm like, yeah.
Here's the thing. It's the equivalent of I feel like it's the equivalent of saying your first Kingdom Hearts was 358 over 2 days.
Okay.
I cannot get over that.
No,
for those of you who don't know that meme, the first Kingdom Hearts game that Justin ever touched was 358 over 2 days.
Okay, I'm gonna actually defend that one. I'm gonna defend that one, but in the sense of, did you not have a PS2?
A gamer baby.
He did not. He was a Nintendo.
Okay.
It's
then fair, I guess?
Oh no, it has nothing. The meme is that it has nothing to do with 358 being a bad game and everything to do with the most confusing place in the timeline to hop on.
I mean, I guess, yeah, but like, for what it's worth, 358 over 2 days would have been, like, well, the PS2 is technically, like, the highest grossing console of all time. Like, the DS is also pretty common thing for, like, pretty decently common portable. The DS was a pretty common portable, and,
I thought for a split. I thought for a split second, I thought the words out of your mouth were going to be the DS is a good console for poor people. I don't know why, but well, I thought that's what you were gonna say.
That's actually not,
Also, by the way, I keep seeing motherfuckers make the joke of, like, did you have a Wii in your house or were your parents still together? The joke's on you. I had a Wii and my parents weren't divorced, so.
Same.
Same.
I did buy a Wii.
The only thing that's going to divorce my parents is death. And even then. But anyways, no,
The DS is an interesting console for horror, I think. I think you could do some cool, like, this is one of the things, right, is I feel like one of the things I feel strongly about in regards to horror media, right, is that I think horror is one of the few things that really encompasses a personal belief I have that medium matters. I think with some things, it doesn't, but, like, I think with horror in particular, I feel like you should always consider your medium, because, like, you can do some wicked shit with, if you consider, like, where and how your scares are being presented. Like, you can't, like, you couldn't present the Blair Witch Project any other way, right? And the same way with something like Silent Hill 2. Like, medium matters. You need to, like, consider the technology and the hardware and the limitations of your thing. And, like, it's part of why I think... Boy, this is becoming a weird tangent. It's part of why I feel like Mandela Catalog in particular fails... is because, it just doesn't need to be analog anymore. Cursed fun fact. Contact with powered lawnmowers kills 951 people in the United States annually.
Anyways, back to, the DS is a good console for poor people.
Kister got a human cast. That's what I mean is, I have a lot of mixed feelings about the way that Mandela Catalog went.
He didn't completely ignore me.
I'm sorry.
You know, no, he didn't hear what I said.
What did you say?
So anyway, the DS is a good console for poor people.
For poor people, yeah. Christ.
What's the Mandela Catalog?
It's an analog web series.
Oh, okay.
But, like, it's a horror thing, but, like, I think, like, for example, I prefer Gemini Home Entertainment. Because Gemini is sticking to its conceit, right? Its tactility is still the same. It still feels like it needs to be on VHS tapes. It still feels like VHS tapes. Like, pieces of its era and of its medium, but, like, I feel like Mandela Catalog really slipped a disc here. And, like, didn't... like, just isn't capitalizing on its medium anymore. And I mean, that's not necessarily a bad thing. Like... in and of itself, I guess. I personally don't like it because I feel like the medium change kind of fucks with the texture of the series overall, but a lot of people still love it, and good on them, I guess.
Okay.
Can't control the churches other people worship at and all that.
Anyways. what we were initially talking about. So, Heaton, get Sonic Adventure and Sonic Adventure 2 on Steam. Sonic Adventure DX on Steam is $1.99 right now, and Sonic Adventure 2 is $2.49. You can get both of them for under $5.
Maybe I'll
do. The only reason I'm not getting them for you
is because you can't.
Entirely because Steam will not let me gift people.
You know what? Maybe I will.
I would also recommend them because I actually really like them. I would also recommend Murder of Sonic the Hedgehog. It's a really neat visual novel.
I saw Salty Keenan play that one too.
However, the ending spoils something regarding Sonic Frontiers. So, I would also recommend Sonic Frontiers first.
Okay.
At least before getting into that one. Unless you are okay with knowing the spoilers of Sonic Frontiers.
I'm gonna say this, I don't want to rain on anyone's parade, but, like, the platforming in Jedi Fallen Order is scrunkly. The platforming in the Sonic games can also be very scrunkly, and if platformers really aren't your thing, you're gonna get frustrated.
Probably. It's alright. I'll give it some think. It didn't block your DM. I got it.
Speak of DMs, thank you for the DM earlier, Heaton.
You're welcome. I thought you would want to see those.
It does
have you seen the latest Gemini Home Entertainment? I did.
Heaton out here understanding my tastes. Now find more princesses.
I got you, dog.
Thank you.
Can't help but find some parts of Mandela funny. I really don't like the actor they got to play the main character, to play the cop. I think he's really bad.
Also, Heaton, I'm not sure if you mean to still have the Trevor Project thing on.
Oh, I didn't, but.
You know what? Screw it. Last day.
Yeah, just fuck it.
Pride Month 2!
Have you ever heard of Fuck It, We Ball?
Fuck It, We Ball.
But, like. I don't know. I don't want to disparage his work, because clearly he's doing a good job. Like, it's well put together, it's just, I don't like it. Honest, I'm still laughing my ass off because people want Mark Heathcliff, dude who dies off screen, to come back. Yeah. I mean, he killed himself! He fucking shot himself in the head! If he comes back, he sure can come back, but we don't fucking want him to, because it's not gonna be Mark anymore. Like, it's just, it's fucking.
Mandela Kellogg.
Screw Pride Month, it's time for Wrath Month. I personally prefer Lust Month.
Well, we can't practice that on Twitch. Scrimblow Catalog, yeah, God.
That, Heaton, we can, you're just not trying hard enough.
Okay, Vita Carnis. I like Vita Carnis. Vita Carnis is cool.
And that's starting now.
Vita Carnis is cool. I like Gemini Home Entertainment. I'm a fan of Mystery Flesh Pit National Park.
I like this Goomy character.
I do as well. Can really sink your teeth into Vita Carnis, as it were. Happy Meat Farm. I've heard about Happy Meat Farm. I've done a little bit of reading on that. That's pretty cool. I'm weird about food-based ones. They make me feel a little weird. I'm not a big baby like Brooke when it comes to cannibalism, but like...
I can't- it makes me want to throw up. I don't know what to tell you. That was...
Listen, some people got squicks. I'm not gonna blame you for that. I will passively tease you as a-
I saw the Walking Dead, the game, and that was the chapter, and I was like, oh, that makes me want to throw up. I know I'm not actually being, like, shamed for it, it's just... I couldn't tell you why!
I mean...
My body...
I mean, yeah, I wonder why, Brooke. I wonder why your body viscerally disapproves of cannibalism. Like...
But, like... Why does it yours?
It did for... It used to. Do with that information what you will.
I don't want...
The mere exposure effect is a bitch.
I mean, it used to more than it does now, but it still does, depending on the depiction. Like, I'm not like you in that, like, any mentions of it make me gag, but, like... Like, let me put it to you like this. There's a section of Mad Kay, which is a story that, pretty much openly starts being based around cannibalism. The opening section where... we are watching it happen on panel makes me feel a kind of way. That gives me a little bit of the erps, but like... But I'm too enamored with the story as a whole to like...
Okay, Google. Stop!
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 I'm familiar with This Room Does Not Exist. I'm fucking 10 steps ahead of you at all times, BB. Beautiful art, but OMG that opener. Yeah, I love Mad Kay. But like there's that one, and then there's one other one that I read that I cannot for the life of me ever remember the name of. That I sat through all in one night, and I read the whole thing, and I was like, dog, this is really good. It's really a shame that I cannot talk about this in most circles. Cause like, I read, every so often, right, I read things that are like, transgressive. Things that are, I guess, like, that are kind of gross. Mainly for, like, to learn more about, like, horror and the self and et cetera, right? The same reason that most people do. And just say fucked up. No, I want to use my fancy academic word. But yeah, I read shit that's a little fucked up. I also don't want it to sound like I'm doing a, like, I'm so edgy. I read stuff that's fucked up. The stuff I read is so... so dark and messed up, guys. But, like, yeah, you know? Sometimes I sit down with a book or a short story or a manga that's, like... That's fucked up! Like, reading Mad Kay, for example, right? And, like...
transgender.
I read some things that are cool, that have, like, cool storytelling elements, or, like... really capture a mood and a place, and then I'm like, this is really cool! I'm, A, never gonna read this again, and B, I super cannot recommend it to literally anyone I know. Cause like, I just don't... Like, let me put it to you like this, right? There's a couple of things that are on, that are not going on the, that are not going in my, like, 2023 roundup video that I've been scripting, where, like, I keep track of all the media, all the movies I watched, all the comics I read, et cetera, right? There's a couple of things that are not going in there just because, like, A, there's kind of no way to talk about them without getting wildly demonetized, and B, because I don't want to deal with the, like, oh, you read a thing that has X in it, and therefore, you know what I mean? Like, I'm already gonna have to deal with that with shit that was widely published, like Fire Punch. When I talk about that kind of garbage, I don't wanna deal with it.
I thought you were going to say when I talk about Jonah, a VeggieTales movie.
Yeah. Oh yeah, the deeply transgressive and wildly fucked up Jonah, a VeggieTales movie.
I mean, people could be onto you for watching something like VeggieTales. I don't know. People are weird.
That's why when I read the Cross series, because it was so gross and bad and I couldn't get it out of my head until I knew the story and hadn't picked it up since. Understandable! Imagine Kaijus, you found the right stream! Welcome, this is a Garth Ennis hate account! This is a we don't like Garth Ennis account. You've stumbled into the right fucking streams, my dudes. I'm so glad that I'm curating an audience full of like-minded individuals. I'm a hater, baby. Garth Ennis is a talentless hack. Good, I'm glad. I'm glad we all agree.
Awesome.
I mean, no, that's true. Like, how The Shining is one of my favorite books, and I think Domestic Violence is A-okay. Heavy sarcasm. True. It's just, it's like... Like, okay, I'm preemptively. Because I know how it sounds to, like, my own ears, right? Like, I'm not reading, like, illegal shit, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not
here-
We
would not let Ian live here if she owns illegal shit.
Yeah, I'm not sitting here, like, reading weird, like... I'm not reading, like, the fucking I almost said the Communist Manifesto. Yeah, the illegal... Karl Marx, illegal. No, like, I'm not reading, like, the Unabomber's Manifesto or anything, you know what I mean? No cheese pizza, yeah. None of that shit. Like, I don't read Lolicon or Shotokan shit, that's disgusting. Like, it's not shit like that. It's just, like... Like, I truly, like, the perfect example of this, right? He's reading Communist Manifesto-based streamer. No, like, I sat down and read shit like, I mean, I keep going back to it, but, like, Mad K is the best example. It's shit like that, right? Like, the central thesis point of Mad K is that it's a story about, a kid with a gore fetish who makes a deal with a demon... to, like, so that he can eat him because he doesn't want to take his kink out on innocent creatures and is reconciling with the fact that he is a monster. You know what I mean? And then it becomes a story about, like, manipulation and, like, Machiavellian scheming and the like, right? It's like, it's shit like that. It's shit that has, like, gross, transgressive elements to it, but, like, for a stronger narrative purpose. Because I hate the shit that doesn't, you know what I mean? Like, motherfuckers kept recommending me, my TikTok algorithm kept recommending me this manga called Brutal. And I sat down with it for, like, two chapters, and I'm like, oh, welcome to another issue, welcome to another fun episode of How Long Until We Get Rape? The answer was it was a plot point in chapter 2, and then I fucking closed the app. I was like, that's enough of that. No thank you. I think I won't, actually. Subversive. Not subversive. I picked the word correctly, transgressive. It's because it, like, it does shit that's bad. Like, stuff that's bad, that's perceived as bad, that's gross, that's meant to be bad and gross and bad and gross. But, like, it's doing it for a purpose. Like, it's, those things are in the story for a reason. It's like why I read, it's like why I read through and really enjoyed Fire Punch. I really liked it, it was really cool. It's a cool story, Fujimoto's incredibly talented, a man does ask a child to fuck a dog. She doesn't, and they kill him brutally, but, like, it's the point of the thing.
That still happens.
Yeah, it's the point of the thing, you know? Twitchy streamer films whoever he wants for his live stream without asking. We'll do anything for clicks. Can't just shove disturbing dark themes into a story without second thought and think it's a mature story. Exactly! They have to be in service to something. It has to serve a point. But what about if I want to explore the depths of the- Shut up! Shut the fuck up! There's never been a bigger red flag to me than when you ask somebody, like, okay, it seems like you did this purely for shock value, what's the purpose? And their response is, oh, well, I did it to explore the depths of the human psyche. Like, shut the fuck up. Like, we already knew that. We've known it for years. You throwing newborn babies at car windshields is pushing what boundary? Is providing what commentary? What insight? Like, have a point. Like, I don't think, for example, right? Like, I'm also in the camp of, like, art doesn't need to thank you for the follow! Every time I go on, like, a weird tangent and then I get a follow, it reinforces my weird behavior. I just need you to know that. You're reinforcing my freak train of thoughts. Fucking Serbian film being like, we're fighting censorship. No, you're not. Like, coffee good. Welcome to the chat. Just every time somebody does it, every time I like go on a tangent and then I get a follow, my brain it provides the dopamine of like, no, I'm correct. I want to hear this stuff and I just got here. Hell yeah. Welcome to rambling about horror and obscene content. Fucking Serbian film. Sorry, I wanted to finish that thought. Being like, we're fighting censorship. No, you're not. Well, like, Serbian film was a lot of things, right? It was their fighting censorship, it was a commentary on, like, the way that Serbian films in and of themselves were increasing in shock value purely for shock value's sake. And, like, I'm with you, preemptively. Just want to say, with you in that, like, that's how we wanted to make that statement? Like, That's how we wanted to push that boundary, how we wanted to set those limits, you know? But, like, listening to the creators talk about it, I think a Serbian film genuinely did want to do those things. I think it just did them very badly. Like, I don't think they're lying when they say that. I just think they fucked up in doing what they set out to do, basically. Garth Ennis takes a breath, me, shut the fuck up, you talentless hack. I think the thing I hate the most about Garth Ennis and about his work is that you can tell, it's not even that he doesn't have any talent, because, like, there's themes and stuff in stuff like The Boys that you can totally pick up on that are present that you can, like, tell were in there intentionally, that were thought out. There's a message that's being conveyed. Again, I don't think it's conveyed well, but, like, it's there. I think the main issue that I have personally with Garth Ennis is that his shit is so fucking bitter.
It's so bitter. There's so much contempt in it.
Yeah, you can tell that he's not doing these things or saying them because he cares about the things he is talking about. He's not like... I forgot to record this time lapse, goddammit. Fuck.
Now you can't prove that the art isn't AI!
But, like, you can tell that, like...
Okay, even if you don't have the time loop, you do have the VOD.
I do have the VOD. Boys comment, good themes, literally swallowed up and forgotten about for the sake of increasing shock value. Exactly! Like, it's, again, it's a case of... I think Garth Ennis had something to say... But I think he said it so fucking... He said it through clenched teeth.
He had something to say, but didn't know how to say it.
Yeah.
No, he said it poorly because it got obfuscated.
Because he's a fucking bitter old man. He just fucking... He's talked time and time again about how much he hates superhero comics and how he feels like they're ruining the industry and destroying the medium and whatever. And, like, if he wants to be a sour, bitter bitch about it, then he can be a sour, bitter bitch about it. But, like, he wasn't saying anything. But yeah, exactly. Say it somewhere else. He wasn't saying anything that Watchmen didn't say before him. Or either before him or better, whichever is the case. And, like, I didn't like Watchmen either, which is a hot take. Like, I just feel like a lot of the things that Garth Ennis does and says in his work are either, like, purposeless or, like, not... They don't do anything to serve the work, you know what I mean?
You know, what's...
Changing Stormfront into a really obvious SS officer into an alright Nazi dog-whistling e-girl was a much better direction for the character. Yeah, like, I think it's part of why, like... I can say that I'm not gonna watch the show because, like, I don't have any interest in it, mostly. But, like, I can tell you from the bits of it that I've seen that the show is a notable upgrade from the comics because it seems like the people working on the show understood... They really were just sifting through a crackhead's ramblings about the government and were like, listen, maybe he's onto something. They just took all of his fuck shit about lizard men and anti-Semitism out of the conversation. I'm not saying Garth Ennis is anti-Semitic, by the way. I'm just for the sake of the fucking metaphor.
Does he believe in lizard men?
I'd believe it if you told me that if he came out tomorrow and said that he did, I'd believe it. But like,
I believe the lizard from Spider-Man exists. We just need to find Dr. Kirk Connors.
Hello, everyone. How are you? Fine, thank you. Oh my god!
What the f-
It's an Azumanga Daioh reference.
Okay. You see, I'm uncultured. I have not watched Azumanga Daioh.
See, I think Alan Moore is pretty much just Ennis, but has a funny accent, so people listen to him. Here's the thing, right? I think Alan Moore has some interesting things to say, and has put forward some interesting narrative plot points and some things that he's written. Read as, I really like V for Vendetta, and I think V for Vendetta is very good. Asterisk, I also think Alan Moore is insane.
The band's crazy.
I joked about this before, but like, if I saw a headline tomorrow that was like 15 bodies found buried in Alan Moore's backyard as beloved comic author convicted of ritualistic murder, I would not double check that headline before I went, yeah, that makes sense. Like, he's nuts. He's insane. And we're not gonna pretend that he's not. It's just that his insane scrawlings are actually kind of funny to watch sometimes.
Also, V for Vendetta has the rawest quote ever. A.
V Before Vendetta yeah. He's Watchmen, right? Alan Moore did V for Vendetta, he did the comics version of League of Extraordinary Gentlemen.
Was he Killing Joke?
He was Killing Joke. Like, he's...
Wait, he did Killing Joke?
Yeah. Killing Joke's Alan Moore. Some good lunch after perhaps getting bullied by another streamer. Oh no! Did you deserve it? Were you wearing the purple suit?
Were you wearing the purple suit?
Yes.
Then you deserved it.
You deserved it.
Yeah, I think like 100% more misses more often than I think the community wants to admit, but like...
He has more to say and isn't a cynical asshole about it.
Yeah. Alan Moore is a fucking deranged lunatic, but at least he has something to say and the shit that he says is interesting. Like, I'm not gonna pretend that Tarantino, for example, isn't absolutely fucking deranged as well, but like...
Who let a foot fetishist become a critically acclaimed director?
Like, Tarantino's whack. I love listening to interviews with the man because he's absolutely fucking insane. Like... Listening to Quentin Tarantino talk is just consistently funny. It's hilarious and it's fascinating. He's just a very weird individual. But like... But I am not gonna pretend that he's like an enlightened genius. He's just fucking deranged, dude. And sometimes he says some cool shit.
Sometimes says some cool shit, and that's about it.
It is literally just...
Welcome to today's Heaton-based hot take. I think that the best movie that Tarantino has ever made is Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, followed very swiftly by Pulp Fiction, and the only reason I would put Hollywood above Pulp Fiction, despite loving both of those movies, is the fact that Once Upon a Time in Hollywood is a lot happier of a movie, and it was much more pleasant to watch.
And it wasn't weird fanfic, and it was respectful fanfiction.
Well, like, the thing about Charles Manson in that story is such a background note. Like, it has nothing to do with, like, the main plot points. It's just kind of something that happens in the movie.
It doesn't matter, it's still respectful fanfiction.
Yeah, as opposed to The Haunting of Sharon Tate. We have to watch The Murder of Nicole Brown Simpson. I have to watch that fucking movie. I have to see that follow-up. I hate that fucking movie. It's such a fucking bad movie! It's so awful! The fucking cinematography's bad, the fucking acting's bad. The fucking story's deranged. They made one about the OJ. Yeah, it's the same guy! It's the same fucking weirdo who wrote his weird fucking manifesto screed to Sharon Tate's sister. It's the same guy. He wanted to- oh, did I not tell you about this?
We got some new people in here who do not know the lore of how much you hate that movie. That movie is so fucking bad. I wanted to pause the movie every 5 seconds to talk about how it's so fucking bad.
So there's this movie. It's called The Haunting of Sharon Tate. And it was written by an absolute fucking psycho. Like, this dude's creepy as hell. He wrote... So for those of you who don't know, Sharon Tate was one of the women who was murdered by Charles Manson in the 80s. This director wrote a movie where she gets, like, psychic dream visions about being murdered and writes a, like, AU historical fanfic about Sharon Tate surviving being murdered. I just want that to sit for a minute. Just want you to sit with that one for a second. it's like heinous. It's so disrespectful, first of all. Second of all, it's just a very bad movie. Like, even if it wasn't super gross and disrespectful, like, it paints...
It's just bad.
It paints Sharon as this weird, like, this weird virginal Madonna. It's so creepy. It's serial killer shit, ironically. Told me something like that as part
I
of their plotline. It's so fucked up.
Glorified Charles Manson. Yes, you do.
Yes, you do. Turns him into the literal boogeyman. But, like, okay, so that movie's fucking insane, right? Like, it's deranged. It's actually fucking bonkers. The funniest part is, so Sharon Tate's sister is still alive. Deborah Tate, I think, is her name. She's still alive. And she wrote, like, a fucking scathing takedown of that movie. Because it's, like, it was horrible. It was so disrespectful to her sister and her sister's friends who died with her. Just awful. So she fucking absolutely destroys this man verbally. She's like, this is disgusting. It's cashing in on her death. And this motherfucker writes her the creepiest fucking stalker letter I've ever fucking read in my life. He talks about, like, yeah, she was pregnant. But he writes her this fucking so creepy stalker letter where he's like, I've been thinking of your sister ever since I was like 5 years old. It was a formative experience for me. I wanted to give Sharon the chance to live that she never got to have. Like, just the fucking creepiest shit. The creepiest fucking shit. It's so gross. It's so gross and so weird, right? So, like, flash forward, right? This motherfucker makes another movie. Another, like, what if they lived story. And it's about fucking Nicole Brown Simpson. It's about fucking OJ's wife. And first of all, I need you to know something, that the one thing that I know about that movie, right? Because I know one thing, a singular goddamn thing about that fucking movie. I haven't seen it. I've purposely avoided any kind of information about it because I want to go in so blind. He forwards that whack conspiracy theory that OJ didn't do it. He genuinely thinks OJ didn't do it. Which is fucking bonkers. Actually bonkers. Now, here's the thing. He thinks OJ doesn't do it. So it's not about OJ killing her. It's about, I think it's their gardener or something. I don't remember. But, like, he said he wants to create a supernatural true crime cinematic universe. And I do not know how to stress to you how absolutely fucking insane that shit is. I am going to pirate every single one of those movies. He's not gonna see a dime, but, like, oh my god. Like, oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Oh my god?
Like, for example, I have mixed feelings about, like, horror movies like The Chernobyl Diaries, for example, right? Because, like, the family of the people who died in Chernobyl are, like, still alive. Like, it's fucked up. It's kind of a fucked up thing for you to make a movie about, you know? To make your zombie horror movie about, right? Like, we can make Nazi zombie movies because, like, nobody's gonna feel bad about turning Nazis into zombies. Like, who's gonna feel bad about that? Nazis? I don't give a shit about what Nazis think. But, like, It's... When you're... Don't use fucking real events for your shitty supernatural horror movies, please! Please! It's in such bad taste! Especially when the families of those things are still alive! Like... It's like that fucking, Dahmer series, right? It's the same diff. It's like, don't do shit like that. Like, it's
you're
just...
You're just re-traumatizing.
That's all you're doing! You're capitalizing on people's trauma for brand recognition, for lack of a better word. You know what I mean? Like, that's fucked up. Don't do that shit. Cough, cough, yick, cough, cough.
But it was inspired by...
It doesn't fucking matter! He copied it point by point! That woman had to find her daughter's body in a fucking hotel water tower. Because she had a nervous breakdown. Like...
Yeah, it was disgusting. Like, please let it be known that I was being sarcastic.
Yeah, of course.
I think it's fucking gross.
Yeah, exactly. Like, it's so fucking... Ah. I hate shit like that. There's no mystery of Elisa Lam. We know what happened. Exactly! We know what happened! It was a mystery at the time! But, like, now we do know what happened. And it's, like... Like, I've heard there's a bunch of movies about, like, Junko Furuta, for example, and, like, that's so wild. Like, after all the terrible things that were done to her, that her parents had to be re-traumatized through that trial, like, that's so deeply fucked up. It's so fucking wildly inappropriate, and motherfuckers do it constantly, and it's so fucking gross. It's so gross. My friend Dahmer was one of those extremely weird. Wait, how the fuck did you pull me into this? Oh, right, we're high. Streams with a few odd people. Wouldn't know anything about that. Especially if the victim's a teenage girl. Exactly! Like, there's just... Listen, a lot of people want to believe, for some reason or another, that when it comes to horror, there's like, oh, I can do whatever, because it's, you know, if it makes you upset, it makes you uncomfortable, then, like, it's the whole fucking point. It's like, no. No, that's not how this works. You don't get to, like... You don't get to traumatize people for your fucking... You don't get to traumatize people for your art. That's not how this works. It's like that fucking Tarantino quote that's going around now of him talking about, like, I don't think we should have to add trigger warnings to things. It's like, it's not about being offended, you fucking boomer. Like, the idea of walking into a theater, like, for example, right? Like, I shouldn't have to rely on does the dog die to know if Brooke can go see a movie with us. You know what I mean? That's not how it should be. It's an edgelord mindset. Yeah, agreed.
It's important to be... trigger warnings are important so people don't get re-traumatized.
Yeah, a trigger warning is not to, like, not be offensive. It's for traumatic imagery, so that way fucking victims do not have to feel re-traumatized by seeing the events play out again.
What, are you against epilepsy warnings too? Because it causes a physical reaction in someone and causes them to have a medical issue? Is that, you're saying the exact same thing. If you say that trigger warnings are weak pansy shit, then that means you feel the same way about epilepsy warnings, right?
I think that expired by dates are the work of the liberal SJW mafia, and they are simply put there because their weak soy boy bodies cannot handle when the milk expires.
Please do not drink expired milk.
Please do not Don't lick batteries.
I'm going to drink expired milk now.
Keepy no!
Don't drink the Grimace milkshake!
Mimi, alright.
Like, you...
I found an alternate recipe, and that alternate recipe actually looks pretty good, and I kind of want to... We have a blender that we've never used, so we might as well.
I saw someone make an alternate recipe for the Grimace shake, drink it on thing, and then act as if DLC had, like, the follow, like, and it, like, participated in the Grimace shake because of it. It looks really...
I like the idea of, like, doing a totally normal, like, recipe, like, cooking video... Like, on TikTok, where they're like, here's the quick recipe for this, and then they do it, and they're like, let's give it a try, and then it just turns into the fucking Grimace shake trend. Also, I need you to know, our dear Dio sent me a fucking DM, and it's been living in my head rent-free since he sent it to me. On TikTok, this motherfucker DMs me and says, quote, "The children wish to return to Marble Hornets," and then sent me a bunch of Grimace shake memes. And I hate that, because he's right. That's it. That's just the whole thought. It's just, he's spot on. He's just simply got it. Because I was like, why does this feel familiar? It's all Marble Hornets shit. I'll never be able to escape. Somebody, who the fuck was it? Somebody said there was a post. I don't know how many of you will feel the same way I did, but hopefully a few of you. If I've curated my audience correctly, if my algorithms have shown me to the right people, you should understand what's about to come out of my mouth. Somebody showed me artwork of, I think it was Freddy Fazbear, Huggy Wuggy, Bendy, and who was the other one?
Me. Was it Amanda?
Was it Baldy? No, it was older than that. Somebody, like, mascot horror characters, right? And I was looking at them, and I was like, God, this feels familiar. And I think it was, again, maybe it was Tattletale? I think it was Dio who looked at me and said, "Time is a flat circle." And I went, "What do you mean?" And then he just said, "Slender Mansion." And I wanted to kill myself. I was like, "Oh no! No! Come on! I escaped! I escaped this! Not again! The fucking Zoomers are not repeating the mistakes of their predecessors! Go away! Fuck you, Slender Mansion! I want to die! No, stop! I fucking hate it here. I hate it here! I don't want to think about the Slender Mansion ever again! I crossed state lines, you shouldn't be here. This sucks. Really did just fucking come into my home, sucker punch me in my teeth, and then tell me to fuck myself. I don't know that shit. I'm so glad for you, you know? I'm stoked for you that you don't know.
I'm assuming it's like the Smash Mansion, but for like... creepypasta characters.
You got it in one, Brooke! That's where like all of the baby girlification of Jeff the Killer...
happened.
Eyeless Jack, fucking Laughing Jack. Like, that's where that all happened, was usually in the people who liked Slender Mansion. Listen, I'm gonna have a moment, right? Inherently, our dearest beloved Ponder Sprocket is right. B's right. Kids can do whatever they want, they can be as cringe as they want, and they should do it when they're young, when there's the least repercussions for being cringe in public, right? As a horror fan...
As a horror fan, it doesn't mean you have to like it.
Hello, today I am here with a petition to the United States government to remove monster fuckers of their rights. The evidence I cite in case in proof for my claim is that if I have to watch one more goddamn video of Pyramid Head twerking, I think I'm going to commit some kind of crime.
I don't want to be someone that says you're enjoying a thing wrong, but sometimes I feel that I want to be a gatekeepy bitch and be like, you're enjoying a thing wrong.
You can take my rights, but you can't stop me. I mean, I understand fully that I can't stop you. I know there's nothing I can do to make it end. I know that there is no trigger that Piglet can pull that'll save me from you, but like, the least I can do is take your rights away. I just... Doug! Please! You can sexualize so many monsters! There's so many monsters! There's so many monsters in Silent Hill you can sexualize! I turned a blind eye to the nurses, you know? I let you have them, because you know what? It's fine! You can have whatever kinks you desire, but like, fellas, do we gotta sexualize the personification of James Sunderland's inherent toxic masculinity? Really? Fellas, does it defeat the entire purpose of Pyramid Head as a creature? I turned a blind eye when you fucking weirdos wanted to put cat ears on Ghostface, and I'm willing to continue to turn that blind eye, but like... Pyramid Head?! If I can have the nurses then. I don't gatekeep, there are less than a dozen people who understand One Piece. Eiichiro Oda is one of them. It's true. Listen! I'm not saying that certain subsets of the community don't deserve One Piece. What I am going to tell you is a fun and very true piece of information that when the Seraphim were introduced, fucking Eiichiro Oda had to clarify, because people were being weird and creepy, that Hancock's powers only worked as a Seraphim because people thought she was cute, because lolicons were being weird and being like, oh, people think her powers work because they think that she's sexy, when we've established repeatedly that that's not how her fucking powers work. Like, fucking Hancock's a Gorgon's metaphor, boys, come on. She's a fucking Medusa allegory. The whole point is that she uses her sexual charm so that men can't hurt her anymore. That's the whole point. He's going with the modern interpretations of the fucking Gorgon myth. But her powers are rely based on any kind of strong emotional feeling, and Oda shouldn't have had to clarify to you freaks that she was... that it was because she was cute. You should have known better.
I saw that Medusa post and I was really worried for a second that he was promoting Lolly shit, and I was very confused.
No, he would never. Keaton, I got a One Piece question. Hit me with your One Piece question, Daedalus. I may have an answer for you. I may have a One Piece answer. I saw this fucking character immediately and was like, I love everything about this. Just a funky crab. Pretty certain the shape doesn't even know what sex is. Myers' brain is focused on murder, murder, murder. Factually correct. Who are the eggheads and why do people keep drawing hot women as what? Okay, so this is a One Piece spoiler. Egghead Island is the current arc. It's the name of the arc. Because the arcs are usually named after the islands. They're not the eggheads, they're the Vegapunks. So we're introduced to Dr. Vegapunk as a character, like, that exists in the world pretty early on. And all we know is that he's, like, some great scientist, right?
First mentioned in post-Enies Lobby.
Yeah. All we know is that he's, like, the world's greatest scientist. Smart man. Right? And then, later on, we... Now in Egghead, we see him for the first time, and he's done a science. He's separated himself into six. I think it's six. I'd have to double check. Other life forms. And they are the Vegapunks. One of them is a hot lady. That would be... Is it the one with the short hair? If it's the one with the short hair that covers one eye, that's Lilith. She's the one that's... When people do science in One Piece, it's usually bad. Actually! One of the things that I love and absolutely fucking adore is that Vegapunk is not evil. Vegapunk is totally actually a solid dude, and we meet him, when we meet him, the real him, the first thing he says to Luffy is, like, he grabs him by the shoulders and he goes, Straw Hat, get me off the island. The government is coming for me. They're going to try and kill me and take my tech. I don't want that. We need to leave. He is a silly guy. The way that I put it was, think, I want you to picture, like, Dr. Light in your head, like from Mega Man. Kind of like that.
Someone wants to know about Yamato's whole deal. They're a little confused.
He's trans. He's trans. That's it. That's the whole thought. He's transgender. I forgot to record the time lapse again! Fuck! Shit! I'm a fool! So, Yamato, okay. The reason that motherfuckers are clinging to not just admit that Yamato's trans is because Yamato is also a Kinney. It's not a bit, by the way. He is. There's a character that you meet later, his name's Kozuki Oden, and he's cool. He's the sickest. He's the coolest dude in the whole wide world, right? And Yamato really likes him and thinks he's the fucking coolest. And he's like, I want to be just like Oden. And in being just like Oden, I want to be a man. And a lot of people are like, oh, it's because he wants to be like Oden. It's not because he's trans. And I'm like, he is trans. He identifies as a man. Everyone uses he, him pronouns. Kaido refers to him as his son. Everyone in the Beast Pirates refers to him as Kaido's son. Fucking, the only reason that they're being weird about it is because unlike characters like Kiku and Iva, who are trans and either pass or are goofy, because Yamato is a man with titties, they're like, oh, he can't be trans, because if he's a man, then I'm gay. Like,
He can be trans, he just also has nice tits.
From what I understand, there might be some cultural context to why Yamato isn't written the best. If there is, I've never heard it. All I keep hearing is, like, because, like, Yamato doesn't, like, I don't want to say he doesn't do anything, but, like, he doesn't, like, he's not around that much. And, like, unlike characters like Kiku or Iva, like, it's not, all of the, actually, Kiku's a great example, because Kiku's the same way. Like, Kiku is mentioned as, like, the twin handsome samurai brothers, or something like that. And Luffy turns and looks at her and goes, brothers? Or, like, man? Question mark? And Kiku responds, this one is a woman at heart. And then they go, oh, okay. And then they just use female pronouns for Kiku the rest of the time.
Like, Kiku had to be written, at least in the Japanese way, which is why, like in Japanese, from what I'm aware with her, is that Oda used the Japanese way to call themselves trans without explicitly saying it because of the way Japan is and shit.
Right. Kiku
That's
says...
That's why it's translated that way.
Yeah, Kiku says, yeah, this one's a woman at heart. But, like, in the same way that, like, they're like, man? And then Kiku goes, no, heart emoji. And Luffy goes, okay. And then just, like, continues to gender Kiku correctly. It's literally the exact same way with Yamato. Yamato introduces himself as the son of Kaido. Luffy goes, son? And Yamato goes, yes. And then Luffy goes, okay. And then that's it. Like, I don't understand what the, like, weird... Because, like, there's nothing... He's just around and is a man and uses he, him pronouns. And identifies him and genders himself as a male. I don't know.
Listen.
He constantly uses he, him pronouns.
Yeah. Fucking...
Listen.
Yeah.
Listen, he can just have nice titties. It's okay.
Yeah. Like, he uses...
You want me to compliment his titties? I'll compliment his titties. He has nice titties.
He uses the Japanese first-person pronouns for men. Everyone on the Beast Pirates identifies him with male pronouns. Fucking... There's three sources that they use every time. There's one panel where he is referred to as, there's one panel where in, like, the character box, you know, that happens during the introductory box, it says daughter. That's it. Nobody in-universe ever refers to Yamato with female pronouns or as a woman. Then on the Vivre card, he's identified as a woman. Guess what? Not only are the Vivre cards not written by Oda and not canon, they're also constantly wrong. Like, I did a little bit of reading because people kept citing them to me, and, like, everyone is like, you can't use them for reliable information. Like, the Vivre cards are so wrong that they said that Luffy got his powers 10 years later than he actually did. Like, the Vivre cards are just a bad source of information constantly. Like, they're constantly wrong. And then the other source is there's one color spread of all the female characters, of a few of the female characters from Wano, and Yamato is there. And it's like, okay, also, Kiku isn't there, and you've all agreed that she's a woman. Two, okay, I'm glad that Chopper is trans now, because for the Women's Day poster, for the Women's Day color spread that Oda drew, Chopper is there. So I'm glad we know that Chopper is now trans. Like, I don't... Like, all of the sources are stupid. Yamato's a man. He, him, with his... I love that. If Zoro can have giant knockers, then so can Yamato. True!
Zoro has nice titties, too.
Zoro also has big, heavy naturals, but, like, nobody's talking shit about Zoro's fat tits.
Listen.
Women in STEM. Christ.
Like, Yamato is a man. He was just born in the body of a woman.
It's the fucking... It's the... The... Oh, what's his nuts? It's the clip. I'm a man. I'm a male. I'm a he. I'm a him.
Just...
Because every man wants to fuck Zoro. It's true.
It's true.
Which sucks, because Zoro's Ace Arrow, as far as I've headcanoned. All right.
You and I both immediately said, it's true.
It's true.
It's true.
So true and real. Also, Charlotte, yes, read One Piece. Read One Piece. Watch One Piece. One Piece is so good. I hate to inform you that anyone who has been trying to proselytize to you about One Piece is simply right. It's just good.
Speaking of good,
speaking of good, we're gonna raid you over to Dr. Crafty, who is currently, self-harming live on stream by playing Balin all weekend. So go harass him for a little bit. I will see you all Tuesday for more Art Fight. Goodbye!
Goodbye!